Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans and today I want to show you how to use your DDRs as a video editor. Now typically when you think of our DDRs, those are going to be used for video playback with transitions, etc. But you can also use some pretty cool simple steps to turn these media players into a basic video editor. So let's take a look. Alright, so here we are in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and I'm going to bring up a clip that I just created real quick to show you how to do some very simple editing within the TriCaster. So let me go ahead and hit play on my DDR clip, which is over here in my preview window. So I just have a little broadcast here where I have these two subjects just talking back and forth. And then you'll notice in the middle of this that I did a bad switch over to my bicycle shot here. That doesn't need to be there. So I want to be able to take that out without having to render out that footage and then take it into, say, like an editor like Premiere or Final Cut, etc. So we can do some trimming directly from our DDRs. So check this out. Let's go ahead and focus on DDR1. And so what we can do is I can hit play, and then just watching the timeline here, I can see when that happens, or I can scrub through the timeline as well by just simply clicking on this box and just dragging it around. All right, and then, oh, there it was. There's a little mistake here. We want to get rid of that. All right, now, when you're doing this, sometimes if you have a very long clip, scrubbing through your timeline can throw you off a huge amount of time just by doing the scrub. So if you're just using your mouse like this, for example, or check this out, you can hit Control, and that will allow you to scrub just a frame at a time. So just a little tip there. All right, so that's a good place for me to make a cut before the bike shot comes in that I did by accident. So to do a cut from here, all you have to do is go to the clip itself, right click on it, and you have all of your different options in here, like cut, copy, etc. But that basically just removes it from your DDR. But underneath remove, you'll see that I have split at current frame. Check this out. Boom. Now I have two sides of the same clip. And you'll notice that in the timeline that I have the first area before my cut and then the second area after my cut. So that cut right here, that one's fine. We'll leave that one alone. And let's focus on the second part of it here. So let's go ahead and scrub through the timeline again. And there's my bike. I want to cut him out completely. All right. Right about there. Okay. Now, I can do another cut point here, but honestly, if I do that, that will create another clip that I just need to delete. Or I can use my set in and out points here to make that a little bit easier. So I'm just going to say set in, and now that is gone. So let's go ahead and I'm going to play that clip back, and let's take a look at how that works. So hit play, and then it'll go to the next clip. Boom! And my bike rider is gone. All right, now I'm gonna let this play out a little bit more because I just showed you how to do a cut in here, but there's also some other fun things you can do as well. So you'll see that at the end of this clip, you'll see that I will cut over to a weather broadcast. All right, that looks pretty good. But let's say I wanna do something a little bit fancier than just doing a cut. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna go through here and let me cut the end of this off a little bit, you know, just right after her smile. All right, so I'm gonna go to this clip again and click split at current frame. All right, now I have my third clip over here. And now let's scrub over through the timeline and go to my weather report when it starts right about here, just a little bit of lead time. So I'll set my endpoint here. And now instead of doing a cut, I can add a transition. So let me just, I'm gonna select both of these clips here and then click on my plus button at the very bottom of my DDR. And then I can go through and find a transition that is in my list. So for example, let's grab this one here. Just anyone, just for example. All right, cool. Now see that I added a transition to the end of it. I'm gonna go ahead and just click plus here, and sorry, delete and get rid of that one because we don't need that. But okay, so now let's just go ahead and I'm gonna hit play from the beginning and we're gonna watch this broadcast go through. So first up, we have our speaker number one, and then we're gonna go to speaker number two, and then we'll see our cut. Goes back to speaker number one, pretty good. All right, and then he talks for a bit, and then we'll go back to our second speaker. And then here comes a transition into my weather broadcast. Check this out. Boom, done. That's all I really needed to do. And as you can see, that makes it very, very, very simple for you to edit your broadcast on the fly without having to go back into your production and say, cut it with Final Cut Pro or Adobe Premiere. So as you can see, DDRs can save you a lot of time if you're in a pinch, if you just need to edit something quickly. Now, if you like this video and want to learn even more about NewTek products, please talk to your local reseller or visit newtek.com. And for more video tutorials like this one, subscribe to our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtekinc. You can also sign up for a free NewTek product demonstration by going to newtek.com/demo to get a free interactive TriCaster demonstration from one of our sales specialists. Well, that's all for today. Thank you all for watching, and we'll see you next time on another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.